perverts tied up a woman, gang-raped her, robbed and abandoned her. And then Bhopal cops at three different police stations mocked the survivor and turned her away. But the 19-year-old Braveheart fought back, caught the bees who gang-raped her and showed the cops how to do their jobs. And then she was shamed.
This is the medical report of the minor girl who was raped by four people. And I'll ask my camera person to zoom in and you'll be able to say that clearly it says that they had sexual intercourse with her consent and will.
As outrage erupted over this shocking attempt at cover-up, authorities rushed to give a list of excuses.
ये मानवीय भूल है, उसको ज्ञान नहीं होगा, अनुभव नहीं होगा, बाकी ये नहीं लिखा जाता।
मतलब ये गलती मान रहे हैं, गलती हुई, ये बहुत बड़ी
गलती क्या? अब ये नए जो ट्रेनिंग वगैरह लेते हैं और जो पीजी करते हैं, उनकी मानवीय भूल है जिसको तत्काल सुधार लिया गया है।
This is victim shaming at its worst, and the state machinery has failed the survivor at every step of the way. On the urban debate tonight, Mirror Now asks, is the state deliberately trying to cover up the case? How can government doctors make such a huge blunder and get away? Mirror Now reports.
How many times have we had to have this conversation about victims of rape or survivors of rape who have to fight the system after they survive the crime and the mental agony that goes with it? Now we know why. We've had activists come onto this show repeatedly, night after night, talking about how public hospitals or government hospitals mistreat survivors of rape. How data is misrecorded, evidence is misrecorded, and they're treated badly. In this particular case, I want to keep reminding our viewers that the survivor is the daughter of two police officers. Both her mother and her father were police officers, and they had trouble getting their FIR actually registered. They were told that they were making up a filmy story. And after getting that FIR registered, after going to four different police stations, when they were sent to a government hospital, which is the procedure in our country, when they were sent to a government hospital for the rape kit test, the government hospital has written out a report that says, as per the accused, instead of calling her here the complainant or the victim or the survivor, they call her the accused. So this is the level at which these reports are written. She was going home from her coaching center at 7 p.m. through the railway station. Two boys took her to the nearby sewage pipe in the tunnel, where they had sexual intercourse with her consent and will. No wonder it is almost impossible to get justice in this country if you are a woman who is a survivor or a victim of sexual crime. What will the government say this time? Joining us on the show, Prakash Mirchandani, spokesperson of the Bhopal BJP, Priyanka Chaturvedi of the Congress Party, Ajay Dubey is a social activist, Abha Singh is an advocate and activist, Swaranjit Sen, former Director General of Police, Andhra Pradesh, Yogita Bayana is also a social activist, and Amit Khemka is a lawyer with the Supreme Court. I welcome all of you to this conversation. Abha Singh, when this case finally goes into prosecution, reports like this will derail the entire process of justice. So while the government might turn around today and say it was a clerical error or the person was not trained well enough, this clerical error could cost the girl in this question her entire case. Isn't that true?
Absolutely, because that time the defense is going to say that you see yourself, it was consent, the girl was of a bad character, they will cast aspersions on the character of the girl, which happens most of the time of the victim. And here, how can it be a typographical error? You are supposed to correct it, recheck it, and then send a report. It is not some romance or a letter which is being sent, it is a forensic report, which is a medical report, so that the doctor is supposed to recheck it and then send it. So just saying it's a typographical error, you are indirectly trying to help the rapist in making their case and later on turn the trial. So investigation needs to be done whether the doctor who was preparing it, as you remember in Arushi case also, the doctors who were doing the viscera, who were doing the forensic test, they were approached, phones were they were called up. So the policemen who have been suspended in this case, those who were not registering the FIR, there are quite probably there are chances that they have approached this doctor, asked him to give a report like this so that they can go scot-free and the trial falls flat when it comes for hearing. So there is a corruption in this involved, there is an intrigue and criminal conspiracy. And FIR needs to be registered that why this has happened. It is just not something which meets the eye that it is a typographical error. How can you say a 19-year-old girl, four people rape her, and you say it was consensual? You say she knew? A girl who wants to join the civil services is going for coaching. Your beti bachao, beti padhao, both have fallen flat because neither could you protect that girl, and that girl was taking the IAS. She was coming, traveling 1 hour every day to prepare for the IAS exam. And I'm surprised that not a police officer has been arrested, because 166A of the IPC clearly says, if you do not register a case, there can be an FIR on you of 166A, where imprisonment is 6 months to 2 years. So rather than jailing those cops, you now have further destroyed the case by saying it's a typographical error. And let me tell you, these are the reasons that conviction in rape cases is only 28% in India. Purposely, these cases are made to fall.
अजय दुबे joins us in the in our Bhopal studio. अजय दुबे जी, आपने पिछले बार जब आप आए थे हमारे शो पे, आपने कहा कि ये होता ही रहता है. क्या आपको लगता है, जैसे आबा सिंह ने कहा कि ये साजिश है, या आपको लगता है कि टाइपोग्राफिकल या क्लेरिकल एरर था यहाँ पे?
नहीं, आबा सिंह जी का जो लीगली बिल्कुल उनका ऑब्जर्वेशन सही था कि ट्रायल में इसका बेनिफिट एक्यूज्ड को मिलता है. लेकिन एक जो इम्पॉर्टेंट चीज है कि स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एमएलसी के लिए जिसको ऑथराइज करती है वो डॉक्टर होता है. ये जो पर्टिकुलर जिसकी रिपोर्ट है ये उसके लिए ऑथराइज नहीं थी, ये जूनियर डॉक्टर थी जो यहाँ पर पीजी करते हैं और देन ये गवर्नमेंट के परमानेंट एम्प्लॉय नहीं माने जाते हैं. इनकी रिपोर्ट सर्टिफाइड नहीं होती है. इसलिए मध्य प्रदेश में बहुत सारे रेप केसेस में इस तरह की रिपोर्ट्स को ट्रायल कोर्ट नहीं मानती है, क्योंकि गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉय ही एमएलसी को सर्टिफाइड करता है. नंबर वन. नंबर टू, हम लोग ये देख रहे हैं कि जब से ये हादसा हुआ है स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एक अपनी डिक्शनरी में वर्ड गैप कर चुकी है, अकाउंटेबिलिटी. पुलिस है तो 72 घंटे वो केस ही दर्ज करती है और जो डॉक्टर है वो एक्यूज बना रहा है. आप तमाशा तो देखिए, सरकार कहां है, मतलब मुख्यमंत्री कहां, कौन, मतलब जिसको जो चाहे कर रहा है. मतलब एक तरह से हमारे यहां कोई रूल ऑफ लॉ चल रहा है, क्या मजाक चल रहा है. जो कागज आप लोग देख रहे हैं वो लीगल डॉक्यूमेंट नहीं है, इसके कारण कन्विक्शन रुका हुआ है. सैकड़ों केसेस ऐसे हैं जिसमें कोर्ट इसको एक्सेप्ट नहीं कर रही है. क्यों? क्योंकि जूनियर डॉक्टर कोई गवर्नमेंट का परमानेंट एम्प्लॉय नहीं होता है, वो अपना पीजी कर रहा है, उससे उन्होंने काम करा दिया. जिस तरह से इस लड़की के साथ टॉर्चर, मैं मानता हूं कि वो चार लोग जिन्होंने रेप किया वो क्रिमिनल्स थे, उन पे सीआरपीसी आईपीसी आप लगाइए. स्टेट गवर्नमेंट उसको मेंटल टॉर्चर करके, ये रेपिस्ट से कम नहीं है. आपने सिस्टम ही धज्जी उड़ा डाली. कैसे कोई हॉस्पिटल मजाक कर रहा है, एक्यूज बना दिया, कंसेंसुअल कर दिया. अरे वो बच्चा कोचिंग से घर जा रहा है, वो वहां पे क्या, मतलब हद हो गई आपकी. और एक भी स्टेट गवर्नमेंट का आदमी ये नहीं बोल रहा कि साहब ये तो हमारे जो डायरेक्टर था जो जिस हॉस्पिटल का, ये उसको करनी थी, उसको सस्पेंड करिए, उस पर क्रिमिनल केस आप फाइल करिए ना. आज ये डॉक्यूमेंट वायरल हो रहा है, उस बच्चे को आप 7 दिन से लगातार टॉर्चर करते जा रहे हैं. आप उसके नेता लोग उसके घर जाते हैं, उसके पूरी भीड़ जाती है. वो दिल्ली से कोई नेता आता है, कोई मध्यप्रदेश सरकार का है, वो तो ऐसा लग रहा है जैसे कि मतलब सारे लोग इस समय उसके घर जाके उसको पब्लिसिटी, और ये क्या मतलब, मैं ये मान रहा हूँ कि जिस जगह आप जिस स्टेट में फास्ट ट्रैक कोर्ट की बात होती है, जहाँ कन्विक्शन की बात होती है, वहाँ ये सब कमजोर करते जा रहे हो आप कानून को, आप तमाशा बना रहे हो और कुछ नहीं है।
Other members of the panel right now, Priyanka Chaturvedi of the Congress, and we are waiting for Prakash Mishandani of the BJP to join us. But in the meantime, our viewers can leave their comments on involve.in. You have to just log on to involve.in and type out your comments. It will automatically pop up on the screen. Priyanka Chaturvedi, it is unfortunate that to be a woman in this country means that justice is always that much further away from us as it is from the men.
Absolutely. I have been part of many such discussions and I don't see any changes happening. I sound like a broken record every time I come on these panel discussions, expecting some things to change, some things to give for our women, but it hasn't happened. It's extremely unfortunate and telling of where women stand in terms of priority. They only stand as politicians are asking vote from them, talking about women's safety, but not ensuring that they get safety. I have been talking about three major points. One is that we should concentrate more on prevention rather than prosecution. Prevention is most important. We don't see anything happening on that. And if you see the entire chain of process, that the process that a woman has to go through, firstly, having to go through a painful incident like that. Secondly, interacting with our bureaucracy, interacting with our police men who are absolutely insensitive. And this is, I think, one of those classic cases where not just the government, but every step has failed her, of the system has failed her. I just like to mention this because not that I want to politicize it, but considering Madhya Pradesh has been for the past 10 years has been recording the highest number of sexual offenses in the country. For the past 5 years, rape cases are the highest in Madhya Pradesh. I would have presumed, I would have hoped that it would become a priority for the state government. Unfortunately, we see how women are failed at almost every step of the way. So this is something that every state government needs to address. And I do not wish to politicize it. I speak more as a woman. And I would hope to see men becoming more sensitive, governments becoming more sensitive, our police system becoming more sensitive, and a bureaucracy becoming more sensitive to situations. Now that a crime has happened, ensure that she gets justice rather than having to run from pillar to post. I'm totally heartbroken when I heard the previous spokesperson before me, Mr. Dubey, I think, from Madhya Pradesh. And it's just too heartbreaking to even comment on this particular case.
Mr. Swaranjit Sen, when the four different police stations did not agree to file this this person's claim, we had demanded that these policemen be arrested under the new laws post the Nirbhaya case. They have not been arrested. Some of them have been transferred. Would you say that this is this sort of leniency that state governments have towards the police that has led to this problem, where reports are being written wrong, where cases are being deliberately weakened against women, Mr. Sen?
Yeah, before I answer your question, I'd like to make a few points. Number one, the police response is simply pathetic. And that is saying it in a very, very light manner. The forensic report is disgusting. Yes, this is what very often happens when cases go to the forensic laboratory and to the forensic expert. We've seen them in our times also. I feel that only the subordinate officers of the police are being targeted. Why? What's happened to the supervisory officer? You see, this is what is called a specially grave nature crime. And a specially grave nature crime is investigated by a gazetted officer, not left to the underlings. Why was that not done? Then, in that general area where this happened, there are two police organizations which are functioning. One is the railway police and the railway protection force. Now, are we to understand that the police is so inept that nobody cares about the place where they're conducting a criminal offense? What is wrong? Where is the presence of the police? Right. The presence of the police has to be felt.
Yes.
And in this case, it is absolutely absent.
Mr. Sen, forgive me for a second. I'm going to interrupt you. I apologize.
We have
Dr. Karan on the phone line, who is the supervisor at the hospital where this terrible report was written, and he joins us right now. Dr. Karan Pipre, thank you for joining us. Dr. Pipre, what is the excuse right now from your hospital or yourself as supervisor for this report that we are now looking at in this case? Aapke hospital mein ye kaise hua?
Actually, the report was given by, or MLC was done by RMO, second year RMO doctor Khushbu. And by mistake, he wrote accused in that report. In spite of this, she should write this.
Why was the report being done by a second year RMO and not by a supervising doctor or a more senior doctor?
After completion of MBBS degree, every doctor has been registered under the Medical Council of India, and they are authorized to do the these report in medical colleges and different.
So after doing their MBBS, these doctors can't tell the difference between victim and accused, and they can't tell the difference between consent and no consent?
It was we asked all these things and investigated. It was human error. By mistake, he wrote this thing, and after very short period, when police constable again come back for this correction, he corrected, and a corrected report was handed over. And we have also instructed to all doctors, RMOs, consultants, medical education professors, readers, and lecturers that they should be along with the examination and RMO, and they should check and write the and give.
Dr. Karan Pipre, what sort of a system are you running there in Bhopal where your doctors cannot even write out a report without making mistakes like this? And you do realize the difference between consent and no consent is the entire basis of a rape case.
I would like to come in here.
Dr. Mr. Saranjit Sen, go ahead. Mr. Sen.
I would like to come in here. Yeah. Yeah, I would like to ask this doctor whether he thinks this case is so light and so inconsequential that anyone can examine the victim. Is this how you treat cases like this, which are of specially grave nature crime? What is your responsibility, doctor? You're supposed to be a superintendent, okay? And this is not the kind of response that I expect, especially in a case like this. Or were you not informed that this is a case which has come to your hospital? I'm sorry, your response is pathetic.
This is the responsibility of every doctor to do or perform all these things, medical legal cases also. And after
hang on. Dr. Pipre, you are still
Dr. Pipre,
you are still not talking about the fact that your doctor in your hospital wrote that the rape happened with consent of the victim.
We know this is very sensitive.
No. Answer my question, please. Your report says the rape happened, which was actual sexual intercourse that happened with her consent. What sort of a medical report is this?
It was wrongly written, or it was by mistake. We had discussed with the higher authority also. They have inspected all these doctors and a senior doctor, experienced doctor, that further this should not be happened, and they will be present at the time of physical examination and internal parts examination, and they should sign the report also, so that this will not repeat.
Who has signed this report? Please tell me. Who has signed this report?
Dr.
Khushbu, he is RMO. He is newly joined RMO.
Abba Singh has a question for you. So this is the level and this is a case, Abba Singh, where the Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan has said he's deeply hurt and he's formed an SIT to investigate the case and probe the lapses of investigation. So while the Chief Minister is making hollow statements like this, the victim is being examined by a second year physician who can't tell the difference between consent and no consent. And Dr. Pipre is actually coming onto the channel right now and saying, no, from now on, we'll all take it seriously.
College Bhopal.
In fact, when a board is set up for giving a report, why is not a senior, mature doctor put? How can a trainee be put in such a sensitive case when this is a case of Article 21, right to
exactly.
life? That
You're
girl's right,
right
to life is at stake, right. her whole career is at stake. And there are Supreme Court guidelines that everything above, right to life supersedes everything else. And here, how could they give it to a trainee? It just shows the sensitivity of the government towards offences, rape cases against girls in Madhya Pradesh. No wonder it is the state with maximum rape cases. And what is important is who chose her. Fix the responsibility, transfer that person. There are medical council guidelines, there are rape guidelines that a rape victim, how she has to be handled, who is supposed to take care. Even if you remember in Arushi case, when her viscera and us was being tested, there were calls made to the doctor. How is it known? How everybody knows that it was Dr. Khushbu?
Dr. Pipre, is this a cover-up? Is this a cover-up, Dr. Pipre? Were your doctors attempting to water down the case, to weaken the case against the victim? Were you trying to cover up for the rapist?
This is very, very, very sensitive matter.
Are you telling me it's a sensitive matter? You are the one who's written a report saying consent and will, not being able to tell the difference between accused and victim.
This was human error. That Dr. Khushbu already accepted this.
No, please tell me. Please tell me. What is in what sort of human error? Does rape turn into consent?
When you say human error, every day planes would crash.
Please tell me, Dr. Pipre,
this cannot be human.
This is not a typed out report. This is a handwritten report.
This certificate will go to the court.
We have informed to Dean Dr. M.C. Songara and head of the department. They are taking the action. This is very serious matter.
Dr. Karan Pipre.
Higher authority will take the action.
Dr. Pipre. Please tell me, this is a handwritten report. This is not a typed out report. In this handwritten report, it says consent, sexual intercourse, they had sexual intercourse with her, with her consent. What sort of human error turns rape into consent? Please tell me. What was the person trying to write?
Yeah, it was wrongly written, and she is not experienced, and the senior doctors was not here. This we have taken very seriously, and we are investigating all these things along with our higher authority. Also, we have taken this very seriously.
No, Dr. Pipre, your justification right now does not make sense. With all due respect, you are telling me it's an error. Now, an error would be, for a handwritten report, would be a spelling mistake or a clerical mistake. But how, instead of writing rape, does one person wind up writing that they had sexual intercourse with her consent? Then two of his friends came and they had sexual intercourse with her one by one. Nowhere in this report is it written rape.
That is why I am saying that we are taking this case very seriously.
You are obviously not taking this case seriously. You are telling me that it is a clerical error.
Higher authority dean will take the action.
What action have you taken against this Dr. Khushbu?
This is responsibility of the higher authority dean, Dr. M.C. Songara, Gandhi Medical College, Bhopal.
So you telling me this is not a cover-up, Priyanka Chaturvedi?
Why shouldn't he be suspended, and why shouldn't the superintendent be suspended?
No, it's not a mistake. Dr. Pipre, if it was such an urgent, serious matter for you, y'all wouldn't have been so insensitive and handed over the report making process to an inexperienced doctor. No, I'm sorry, sir. Your entire defense with regards to this particular letter just reeks of no, incompetency, insensitivity.
Absolutely.
Sir, can I just serve with all.
And you know, I want to point out that this was a case that was commented
just
on.
Just a couple of things.
By the chief minister, by the leader of the opposition, by the school education minister, by the BJP lead of the state. And then when that case went to the hospital, you had a second year resident, someone who was training, write out this report, and you're telling me no supervisor even looked at it before it was signed and sent out. This seems like a complete scam. It seems like the Madhya Pradesh government was underplaying this and weakening this case.
No, we are not weakening. This is the responsibility of head of the department of...
No, and Faye, can you imagine a case under so much media scrutiny can get away with this kind of dilution of case? What happens to hundreds and thousands of women who go through the such incidents and do not have enough courage to go and report it because of the insensitivity at every stage that they face, right from the medical system to the police to everybody, to the bureaucracy? It's extremely, whatever defense he's coming up with reeks of insensitivity in itself. It just angers me no end that what do women on an everyday basis have to go through?
I find it very amusing that Dr. Karan Pipre chooses to give us a lecture right now on how sensitive this case is. I promise you, Dr. Pipre, we fully understand how sensitive this case is, which is why we're talking about it. And I want to understand how you make mistakes like this. How many rape cases come to your hospital on a daily basis? And how often do you people cover up for the accused?
All this was done by the associate professor, and assistant professor, senior experienced lady doctors, along with RMAs, RMOs, those who are posted.
Why?
And they are all doing under the supervision of head of the department.
Why?
So they should all be suspended then?
This will take...
And where is the head of department?
Our senior doctor, senior...
What do you mean by head of department? Where is he?
Head of the department is in the Sultaniya Lady Hospital.
What nonsense.
Abba Singh has a question. Abba Singh.
Behavior on your part.
Abba Singh, please go ahead.
On the hospital's part.
Abba Singh.
Yeah. One thing which they are missing out, Faye, the main important thing when such cases are sent for medical, what was the doctor's job to tell? She had to only tell whether rape had taken place, whether it was a gang rape, but whether it was consent or not was not her domain. She was not supposed to write that. That would have come out after the police investigation. So that means that somebody prompted her to write that word. It cannot come in normal course.
Absolutely right.
Because her
absolutely
job was not
right.
That part that she had to say consent or non-consent. All she had to say was whether rape had taken place, where there were multiple people, whether she had injuries. That is what she had to tell. So that means she has transgressed her domain and there is a criminal conspiracy. There must have been pressure by policemen for her to write these words so that when the case comes for trial, these cops can go scot-free. Because the doctor was not supposed to tell whether it is consent or non-consent.
Abba Singh, let me just read out this report to you. It is despicable. It's disgusting. This is what the state is doing. It says, two boys took her to the nearby sewage pipe tunnel where they had sexual intercourse with her consent and her will. Then two of his friends came and had sexual intercourse with her one by one. They kept her around for 2 or 3 hours, left her over there. Before that, they had sexual intercourse with her again and robbed her of her earrings and her cell phone and her wristwatch. Nowhere. Please tell me how this report amounts to a clerical error.
This language is so insensitive. This language itself is
raping her. It is a... Planted
like
report. The doctor has been forced, or she was given money.
We are investigating.
Doctor Pipre, this is not a medical report. This is a news report. This is a police report. Where is the medicine in this? What is this report? What doctor is writing a report like this? What are they supposed to when they do a rape kit, a vaginal swab, and check under the nails and do a report? What are they supposed to be writing, and what have they written here?
We have issued the so-called notice for all these things and investigating all these things. Then we will submit the report.
Are you now, Dr. Karan Pipre, going to pull out every single report that has been written in this hospital and check it one more time? Because obviously, you people are doing your work in your sleep. You have nobody checking, so you have only two choices here. You're completely incompetent and your entire hospital is incompetent, or you are currently working for the rapists and you're trying to cover up for them and you're trying to protect them. Which of the two options is it, Dr. Pipre?
No. This is wrong. Do not blame on me. I am a doctor. I am working
medical
since
corruption.
Last 37 years. You know, I am working since last 37 years. All these are my... daughter, mother, sister.
So how did this happen?
It was a mistake. We are
But then you don't know how to write a report. This is a report you said. We are not sweared by your daughter, mother, sister.
We will punish.
You are supposed to give
Ajay Dubey, Ajay Dubey.
Your medical report
don't
is going to
you
be the
to bracket us into any category. We are coming to you for justice. We are coming to you as citizens of India. Do not bracket us into categories.
You know, wait one second. I just want to take this question to Swaranjit Sen. Former Director General of Police of Andhra Pradesh. Mr. Sen, yeah. This report I just read out to you, which is complete garbage.
Yeah.
It's filth. Please tell me, how could this be an error? What sort of an error are we talking to? Would you write this off as an error if it came to your desk?
It was expected by that Khushbu that wrongly corrected
that
under the supervision of their teachers.
One second, Dr. Pipri, please listen. Mr. Sen is the former Director General of Police, Andhra Pradesh. Listen to him.
Just hold on. No. I feel what has happened is that they've got this doctor who is inexperienced, and probably it is some supervisor who may have dictated the whole thing. Mm. And maybe that this is known to even the superintendent. That's why he's just treating it so casually. I would like to know what the medical secretary of the government has done in this case. Why has he not suspended this superintendent for his lax in supervision and the lax of supervision of the head of department? What is happening here? It's such a serious case, and he's saying it's just a mistake. It's an absolute blunder. Absolute blunder. And that is how it is to be treated. Who's responsible for it? You've already injured the case or spoiled the case before it started. Why? Because some police officers are involved in it. What is the matter? I would like your explanation on that.
But if it wasn't for the media making such a fuss about this issue, this would have been buried. I want every report that has ever been written by this hospital to be pulled up and checked one more time, because this hospital obviously is completely unable to write any reports. And
yes,
I want to ask
you, I
want to ask you this question. Amit Khemka is also with us. Mr. Khemka, I'm sorry I didn't come to you earlier. And I know you have questions as well. This was a case that Shivraj Singh Chauhan, the chief minister, commented on. BJP leader Rahul Kothari, school education minister Deepak Joshi, Ajay Singh, leader of the opposition, all of them commented on how serious this case is. But a second year resident trainee was doing the report. Do you believe any of this, Mr. Khemka?
Now, as Mr. Sen was saying, that we can't believe that this is the normal procedure in the hospital, that the cases of such magnitude are handled by trainees, you know, it cannot be. So the standard procedure has to be that a certain amount of seriousness has to be attached to the investigation or to the examination of such cases. And it cannot be left to the junior people. So it is not true that there are guidelines, there have to be guidelines, there have to be guidelines that only senior people have to deal with it, which this doctor is not telling you, that what are the guidelines which they have laid. After all,
exactly.
11 rapes are taken. Just
sure
one minute.
Knows about
just one minute, doctor. Just 1 minute, doctor. Pipre, you have said enough. Now, he is not telling us as to what were those guidelines. He is not telling that whether there are guidelines or not. If there are no guidelines, because 11 rapes are taking place in Madhya Pradesh every day. After all, there have to be guidelines. After all, they must be knowing that it's a serious matter. After all, there are so many gang rapes. Every day, one or two gang rapes are taking place.
Six a week. Yes.
So, six a week. So that is why it is not possible that there can be any hospital which will allow a junior trainee to even deal with such a case. So it is not possible. Like Mr. Sen's doubt is absolutely correct, that it is a design, it is somebody senior who did not want his signatures to be there on the report. He made this junior a scapegoat and forced her to write this report. So this is absolutely clear. And you can see the series of events, like both the parents of this girl are in police service, and they could not get an FIR registered in spite of the Supreme Court saying in Lalita Kumari's case in 2008 that you have to instantly lodge an FIR.
And then the police is taking 48 hours in registering the case and starting the investigation. It is shameful that the parents of the girl have to drag two accused. They have to do everything.
Okay. I have a question for Mr. Prakash Mirchandani, who joins us right now with the Bhopal BJP. Mr. Prakash Mirchandani, aapne to rapist ko bachaya. Aap rapist ko padhayenge bhi aaj?
नहीं, मैं समझा नहीं आपका प्रश्न का मतलब क्या, भावार्थ क्या है
आपके गवर्नमेंट में? आप क्या करते हो? रेपिस्ट को बचाते हो, रेपिस्ट को पढ़ाते हो, बताइए आपका नया स्लोगन क्या है?
नहीं, क्या रेपिस्ट को बचाना या क्या पढ़ाना, मेरे को ये नहीं समझ में आ रहा।
नहीं समझ में आ रहा है? आपके पहले तो आपके पुलिस वाले FIR दर्ज नहीं करते, आपके अस्पताल वाले ये लिखते हैं कि रेप हुआ ही नहीं, तो ये रेपिस्ट को बचाना बचाने का ही काम है ना जो आपके गवर्नमेंट कर रही है?
देखिए, वो जो अस्पताल में जो मेडिकल रिपोर्ट का जहां तक विषय है, वो नितांत वहाँ पर उन्होंने लापरवाही पूर्वक ये सब रिपोर्ट जो बनी है उसके लिए संबंधित जो जिम्मेदार लोग हैं उनके पास शोकास नोटिस जारी किया गया है और उनसे उनका जवाब मांगा जा रहा है फर्दर कानून के तहत जो भी।
अच्छा, तो आप मुझे बताइए ये केस के बारे में आपके चीफ मिनिस्टर ने कहा कि वो वेरी डीपली हर्ट, आई फॉर्मड एन SIT टू इन्वेस्टिगेट द केस, दिस इज अ वेरी सीरियस केस। ये चीफ मिनिस्टर के बोलने के बाद कि ये सीरियस केस है, आप कह रहे हैं कि अस्पताल में लापरवाही हुई थी, क्या यही होता है सीरियस केस मध्य प्रदेश में? मतलब यही होता है चीफ मिनिस्टर का स्टेटमेंट? सीरियस मतलब क्या होता है मध्य प्रदेश में, समझाइए मुझे।
गंभीर है, मैंने भी
गंभीर आप मतलब आप तो पहले बात पिछले हफ्ते आके बोले थे हमारे शो पे गंभीर है, तो ये बोलने की बात है गंभीर है? काम तो आप कुछ गंभीर आप लोग करते ही नहीं हो।
नहीं नहीं नहीं, देखिए लगातार मैंने उस दिन भी आपके यहाँ डिबेट पे ये कहा था कि जो भी संबंधित लोग हैं जिन्होंने भी निग्लिजेंसी की है या लापरवाही की उनके खिलाफ
सख्त एक्शन होगा। पुलिस वालों में से आपने कितने जन को गिरफ्तार किया बताइए?
नेग्लिजेंस पे नेग्लिजेंस होता जा रहा है और सरकार चुप्पी बांधे बैठी है, तो सवाल तो सरकार पे भी उठता है। हर कदम पे नेग्लिजेंस हुआ है इस केस को लेकर, तो पूछना पड़ेगा कि ऐसे कौन है जिनको बचाया जा रहा है, कौन इस गैंगरेप के पीछे है जिसकी वजह से
पूरे नहीं बचाया केस को खराब
किया जा रहा है। मिस्टर मिर्चंदानी, आप बताइए मुझे ये तीन जो बलात्कारी है, ये जो रेपिस्ट है,
काम है ये कौन है, जो कार्रवाई है वो हो रही है?
नहीं, आप बताइए मुझे ये तीन जो बलात्कारी है इनको क्यों बचाया जा रहा है गवर्नमेंट?
कोई नहीं बचा रहा है, किसी ने नहीं बचा रहा, कोई नहीं बचा रहा।
कंसेंशुअल सेक्स बता देते हैं, वो गलती है, छोटी गलती है वो।
नहीं नहीं, देखिए देखिए मेरी बात समझ लीजिए, वो इंग्लिश का
कोशिश कर रही है
मेरी बात सुनिए।
अरे तो हिंदी में लिखिए ना मिर्चंदानी साहब,
विदाउट की जगह जो आउट लिखने में जो उसने जो लापरवाही करी है उसके कारण से पूरा का पूरा मेडिकल रिपोर्ट का भावार्थ चेंज हो गया।
हां, और इसके कारण पूरी पूरी केस चेंज हो जाती है मिस्टर मिर्चंदानी, कोर्ट में प्रूफ करना मुश्किल होता है और
जो गलती हुई
और जो एक्यूज है वो छूट जाता है।
ये तो बहाने
हमें मत समझाइए मिस्टर मिर्चंदानी, हमें मत समझाइए।
आपको ऐसा लगता है कि बहानेबाजी हो गई?
बहानेबाजी नहीं हो रही है, ये साजिश है।
उनको ऐसा कहना उनका लाजमी है, लेकिन सरकार पूरी शक्ति से काम कर रही है। मध्य
प्रदेश में 35 ऐसे कार्रवाई हुई है होते हैं,
और जो भी व्यक्ति
अमित केम का एज अ क्वेश्चन, अमित केम का गो है,
आफ्टर 8 डेज मिस्टर मीरचंदानी इज सेइंग इट इज लापरवाही,
तीन थाना प्रभारियों को,
हाउ डज ही नॉट नो इट इज करप्शन, हाउ डज ही नॉट नो दैट इट रिजाइन
SSP,
हाउ डज ही नॉट नो दैट?
जितने भी लोग थे उसमें,
आफ्टर ऑल
इट कुड बी, सबके खिलाफ एक्शन हुआ।
व्हाई आर यू नॉट आंसरिंग माय क्वेश्चन मिस्टर मीरचंदानी, दैट हाउ डू यू नो इट इज ओनली नेग्लिजेंस, हाउ डू यू नो इट इज ओनली लापरवाही, हाउ डू यू नो दैट इट इज नॉट दैट दे आर नॉट मिक्स्ड अप विद द क्रिमिनल्स, हाउ डू यू नो दैट? And after, will you take 8 days in coming to some conclusion? It is already 8 days. How many days you want?
मेरी बात सुन लीजिए, उसी दिन तीन आरोपी उसी समय पकड़ा गए थे, सेम डे तीन थाना प्रभारियों को तत्काल प्रभाव से सस्पेंड कर दिया गया था।
तीन आरोपियों को वो लड़की वो बच्ची ने खुद जाके पकड़ा,
नेक्स्ट डे SSP को हटा दिया गया, उसका नेक्स्ट डे IG को हटा दिया गया।
वेंट आउट इन कोर्ट दोस पीपल हरसेल्फ,
जिसकी गलती आपकी जा रही है।
मेरे ऑडियंस को झूठ मत बोलिए, मेरे ऑडियंस से झूठ मत बोलिए।
मिस्टर मिर्चंदानी,
मिस्टर मिर्चंदानी,
किसी भी किसी अधिकारी ने उसको लाइटली लिया है, सरकार वज्र के समान कठोर होकर है,
सबसे पहले आप ही ने लाइटली लिया है।
मिस्टर मिर्चंदानी, प्लीज डू नॉट लाई टू माय ऑडियंस, यू नो दैट इट वाज द विक्टिम हु वेंट आउट एंड कॉट दोस थ्री अक्यूज्ड हरसेल्फ। यू शुड बी अशेम्ड ऑफ योरसेल्फ टुडे. आप वापस आए हमारे शो पे और झूठ बोलने के लिए हमारे ऑडियंस से.
गंभीरता ये होती है कि जब वो रेप के सजेस्टर करने जाती है, पुलिस बेटी केस बता रही हो,
बेटी पढ़ाओ, जनता
ये है आपका मध्य प्रदेश. वन सेकंड, मिस्टर स्वरणजीत सेन हैज समथिंग टू से. एक मिनट मिस्टर मीरचंदानी,
कंसेंशुअल सेक्स है.
Mr. Meechandani, Mr. Swaranjit Sen has something to say. He is the former Director General of Police, Andhra Pradesh. Mr. Swaranjit Sen, exactly a week ago, Mr. Meechandani was on this show talking about how people will be, with this case will be treated with the kind of seriousness that it deserves. He's back again today talking about clerical errors. What is your response to him?
I think there seems to be some kind of definitely some complicity. I'm sorry to say there is some kind of political complicity. And if this is the response to Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao, then I tell you it is absolutely hogwash
what the government is putting forward
and the government itself should be ashamed.
ये कहेंगे और एक घटना के कारण से इतनी महत्वपूर्ण योजना के ऊपर कटाक्ष करेंगे तो ये भी ठीक नहीं.
नहीं इसी इसी के ऊपर
घटना घट गई अपवाद के रूप तो उस पर सख्ती से कार्रवाई हो रही है. आपके सामने
बेटी बचाओ बेटी
पढ़ाओ, 35 केस रजिस्टर होते हैं, ये बात
महिलाओं पर मध्य प्रदेश में अत्याचार कहीं भी होता है सजगता से सरकार उस पर एक्शन लेती है और कार्रवाई कर रही है.
वो आपको नहीं दिखाई देते हैं जाकर मध्य प्रदेश के मध्य प्रदेश के मुख्यमंत्री सब जगह अमेरिका जा जाकर अपनी बढ़ाई कर आते हैं, अपने राज्य की बढ़ाई कर आते हैं, अपने शासन की बढ़ाई कर आते हैं, पर महिलाओं पर जो बढ़ते अत्याचार हो रहे हैं उसको खराब बताना चाहिए. और आपको बेटी बढ़ाओ बेटी बचाओ
में जाकर हमने अपने मध्य प्रदेश की तारीफ करना है, इसमें गलत क्या है?
अच्छा,
योजना बहुत महत्वाकांक्षी योजना है.
झूठ बोलना बंद कीजिए प्रकाश.
विदेशों में लोग कर रहे हैं, पूरा हिंदुस्तान कर रहा है, सारे राज्य कर रहे हैं.
पिछले
स्लोगन को चेंज कीजिए ना, आप अपने स्लोगन को चेंज कीजिए. आप आरोपी को बचा रहे हो, आप आरोपी आरोपी के हायर स्टडीज भी करवा दीजिए ना. फिर
एक मिनट
प्रियंका चतुर्वेदी,
वॉट इज मोर वरीसम इज जस्ट अ मिनट
पिचंदानी साहब, एक मिनट आप सुन लीजिए ना. प्ले
What worries me more is now that the media has highlighted this, we have got to know that how casually the forensics is taken in this country. Because of the forensic reports, Arushi case still has gone undetected. The judges said the case is not proved beyond doubt. Then in Sheena Bora case, also there are issues. In Salman Khan case, the hit and run case, the blood sample was kept for 2 days in the police station. The sample was mixed up and he got advantage of that it came 48 hours late. Is it a way to ensure that cases do not reach the logical conclusion? Is it a modus operandi of the police and the prosecution to ensure that the conviction rate remains low in this country? Why is it that in rape, molestation, all cases they go scot-free? Because of this, I feel an investigation needs to be done in all the rape cases, medical reports, whether every report is compromised. Only then we will be able to give justice to our young girls and women who are being raped ruthlessly. And I think because of these drawbacks, rape is not stopping in this country, even after providing for life imprisonment and death penalty, because that never happens. The case is never convicted because of the criminal corruption of the medical prosecution and the police.
Wait, can I say something?
Yes, Yogita, go ahead.
Faye, in this particular case, this is very shameful. How many people have failed this poor child? I mean, first of all, society failed her. She was raped, gang raped. Second, police failed her because she was running post to pillar to register the FIR. Then there was, I don't know how many people watched one media bite where the SP, the lady cop, was laughing and replying to all the queries of the media. I mean, how many people are failing her now? Hospital, administration, it is nothing.
No, Yogita, you left out one piece where the girl and her parents went out and caught the three accused. पुलिस मिस्टर मीरचंदानी सो प्राउड अबाउट, ही इज ब्रैगिंग अबाउट इट टुडे, ही सेड हमने तीन आरोपियों को एक दिन में पकड़ा, आपने नहीं पकड़ा.
Now judiciary will fail her because of lack of evidence, because what is written here, if that is approved in the court and it goes, judiciary will fail her again. She is, I think she is being repeatedly raped. I'm sorry to use such a language, but this is what is happening. What happened 40 years back in Mathura case, the tribal girl, you know, the minor girl, it was the same case, and after 40 years we are saying the, repeating the same thing, we are discussing the same issues. What have we grown like, have we developed any further in women empowerment? Nothing. We are back 40 years back, we are back to zero. And Tukaram case also, it was the same 10 years back. So we are standing same point zero. We are not moving forward in this capacity at least. There were SOPs set, standard operating procedures after Nirbhaya gang rape. I mean, it was quite evident what they are supposed to do. I mean, this is not a language error. I'm sorry. This is completely fishy and this needs to be taken cognizance.
No, I want to ask Mr. Mirchandani. Mirchandani ji, aapne kaha ki jin lohne गलती की उनको आप शो कॉज नोटिस भेज के आप यू विल मेक श्योर दैट दे आर पनिश्ड. क्या आपको लगता है कि अस्पताल की सुपरिंटेंडेंट को भी नोटिस भेजनी चाहिए?
वेरी करेक्ट, आई एग्री विद दैट क्वेश्चन.
मीरचंदानी जी, किन किन को आप नोटिस भेजेंगे बताइए मुझे.
आपका क्या विचार है अभी, क्यों चुप हो गए जी?
है कि जो जो जिम्मेदार अधिकारी थे, जिन जिन की भी जिम्मेदारी बनती थी, कानून का महता, जो नियम है, जो कायदे हैं, जो कानून है, उन सारे के तहत कार्रवाई हो रही है.
नहीं, आप इसे वेग आंसर मत दीजिए मुझे.
मेरा निवेदन इतना है,
इस रिपोर्ट पे डॉक्टर खुशबू करके सेकंड ईयर रेजिडेंट का सिग्नेचर है. डॉक्टर सिग्नेचर को, डॉक्टर खुशबू को आप भेजेंगे या सुपरिंटेंडेंट को भेजेंगे? किसको भेजेंगे? डिपार्टमेंट हेड को भेजेंगे? शो कॉज नोटिस?
सारी चीजें सुनिए ना. देखिए मेरी मेरा मेरा मेरे को मेरा मेरा निवेदन, मेरा निवेदन सुन लीजिए
जी.
मेरा निवेदन इतना सा है, देखिए मेरी बात है कि आप सारे जागरूक लोग वहां बैठे हुए हैं, जिम्मेदार लोग हैं, समाज के प्रमुख लोग हैं. ये एक जो संस्कारों वाली जो तमाम चीजें बातें हैं, जो समाज में जो क्षरणता आ गई है, संस्कारों में जो कमी आई है, जो जी? आज इंटरनेट के माध्यम से तमाम इस
तरीके, आपकी सरकार में कमी है.
सारी चीजें जो करना है इस देश में, आजादी के बाद से जो हुई है या नहीं हुई है, लेकिन मेरा यह व्यक्तिगत मानना है कि इसमें और अभी प्रगाढ़ता लाने की आवश्यकता है, ये संस्कारों को और बढ़ाने की आवश्यकता है. इस दृष्टिगत ये जन जागृति चलना चाहिए.
प्रकाश मीरचंदानी, कैन यू हियर मी? प्रकाश मीरचंदानी,
और अभी
प्रकाश मीरचंदानी, प्लीज फॉर योर ओन सेक स्टॉप टॉकिंग.
समाज का एक चौथा स्तंभ है, लोकतंत्र में एक स्तंभ के रूप में काम करता है. मीडिया की बात को इसीलिए गंभीरता से लिया जाता है कि मीडिया अगर कोई बात रखता है या मिरर नाव का तात्पर्य यही है कि एक आईना है और आईने में अगर कोई विषय दिखता है तो वो सत्य होता है. इस दृष्टिगत सारी सरकारें इस पर रिएक्ट करती है और सारे लोग इस पर कार्रवाई करते हैं. आज अगर मेडिकल रिपोर्ट में किसी ने भी कोई गलती करी है और वो मीडिया में भी बात आई है,
आई नेवर म्यूट अ गेस्ट, बट आई एम गोइंग टू म्यूट प्रकाश मीरचंदानी टुडे बिकॉज द बाइल ही इज स्प्यूइंग ऑन नेशनल television is not good for any of us.
दबाव बनाने का प्रश्न नहीं है.
प्रकाश मीरचंदानी, if you can hear me.
नहीं नहीं नहीं, मैं किसी को dismiss नहीं कर रहा हूँ.
I am dismissing you, प्रकाश मीरचंदानी, because it is people like you who keep our women unsafe. It's people like you who make excuses. It is the government of Madhya Pradesh. It's Mr. Shivraj Singh Chauhan and everybody who works for him. And it is this doctor on the phone line and this doctor Khushboo and your various police officers who do this. To make excuses, the fact that हमारी समाज में कमी है, कमी तो आपकी सरकार में है. आप ये जो चला रहे हो अभी कि आरोपी को बचाओ, आरोपी को पढ़ाओ, रेपिस्ट को बचाओ, this is all your fault. When will you take responsibility? What is your response, Mr. Mirchandani?
The responsibility is of the entire world, but not the government of the day. The failing law and order for women is not their responsibility. It is a cultural issue.
और हम कर रहे हैं.
नहीं नहीं, मीरचंदानी जी, मीरचंदानी जी, ये बहस आपकी बहुत सुन चुके हैं. हम देखें न्याय व्यवस्था आप संभाल नहीं पा रहे हैं, उसका दोष आप लोगों पे नहीं डाल सकते हैं.
संस्कारों पे नहीं डाल सकता है,
कोई फेलियर नहीं है। आप एक घटना के कारण से इतनी संवेदनशील सरकार को, इतनी एक्टिव सरकार को जो लगातार काम कर रही है।
आप संवेदनशील नहीं है, प्लीज इस बात से
संवेदनशील है,
इस बात से ऊपर उठिए। आप संवेदनशील होते महिला एक हफ्ते में ये मेडिकल रिपोर्ट निकल के आती,
संवेदनशील है आप।
35 विटनेसेस व्यापम के मर चुके हैं, ये खून
पिछले 5 साल से रेप केसेस में
आपस की पॉलिटिक्स मत शुरू करिए। फिर से इतने गंभीर मुद्दे के ऊपर प्लीज पॉलिटिक्स मत शुरू करिए। आप कांग्रेस बीजेपी की पॉलिटिक्स ना करके प्लीज मुद्दे की बात कीजिए ना। आप क्यों व्यापम घोटाले पर चले जाते हैं, क्यों नहीं समझते कि 3 चीज इंपॉर्टेंट होते हैं। सबसे ऊपर प्रशासन होता है, अगर आपका प्रशासन फेल है तो पब्लिक भी फेल करेगी। प्रशासन का सबसे बड़ा दायित्व है महिलाओं की सुरक्षा करना। अगर आपका प्रशासन फेल कर रहा है तो, अगर प्रशासन फेल कर चुका है तो
पब्लिक भी प्रोटेक्शन नहीं दे रहे हैं।
उनका दोष ना दीजिए, संस्कार तो आपकी सरकार के दिखते हैं। जो आप महिलाओं का वोट पाना चाहते हैं पर महिलाओं को सुरक्षा नहीं देना चाहते हैं। 10 साल से आपका ये रिकॉर्ड है मध्य प्रदेश का महिलाओं पे अत्याचार का। 5 साल से आपका रेप केसेस पे हाईएस्ट नंबर ऑफ रेप केसेस मध्य प्रदेश से आते हैं और आप कहते हैं आप संवेदनशील हैं।
अमित केम का
दोष देते हैं आप।
This mistake, if it wouldn't have come out, it would have gone unreported. Thanks to media. Otherwise, अगर ये बाहर ही नहीं आता तो ये तो unreported चला जाता। इनको भी नहीं पता चलता जो संवेदनशील होने के लिए इतने बड़े बड़े बातें कर रहे हैं। पिछले हफ्ते ये चैनल पे बैठ के पुलिस के अगेंस्ट बोल रहे थे कि हाँ हम एक्शन लेंगे। आज क्या हुआ? यू नो इनको पर्सनली ही शुड हैव सुपरवाइज द होल केस।
आई जस्ट वांट टू ब्रिंग इन अमित केम का हियर। अमित केम का, एज ए लॉयर योरसेल्फ एंड आई नो आबा सिंह विल एग्री विद यू, when these cases go into court they become near impossible to prove because of the kind of evidence that's been bungled up, the kind of reports that have been bungled up. But to hear someone from government today say things like hamare samaj mein kami hai, obviously digressing, obviously blaming this on a larger problem, this shows more than anything else that the Madhya Pradesh government has zero intention on this case or any other rape case. Amit Kim ka
fe main hindi mein bolunga jisse ki prakash ji ko samajh mein aa jaye. Maine unse sawal pucha tha ki aapko ye kaise pata ki ye laparwahi hai, aapko ye kaise nahi pata, aap ye baat kyon nahi mante ki ye kisi prakar ki conspiracy hai, ye janbujh kar kiya gaya hai, ye kyon nahi mante. Pehli baat. दूसरी बात यह कि एक इनके यहाँ पर मिस्टर चौधरी हैं जो 8 साल से भोपाल में बने हुए हैं, वो एसएसपी से डीआईजी बन गए और वो 8 साल से उनका ट्रांसफर नहीं हुआ है। इस मुद्दे पर उनका ट्रांसफर किया गया लेकिन उनके ट्रांसफर ऑर्डर में यह नहीं लिखा है कि उनको ट्रांसफर क्यों किया जा रहा है। ही इज स्टिल बीइंग सेव्ड। ये इस तरीके की सरकार का काम है कि उस उसके अंदर ये कहीं नहीं लिखा है कि ये क्यों ट्रांसफर किया गया है इसको, उस आदमी को जो कि इतना पावरफुल है कि 8 साल से वो वहां से हिला नहीं है। ही इज कंटिन्यूइंग इन भोपाल ओनली, ही इज नॉट बीइंग ट्रांसफर्ड एनीवेयर एल्स।
तत्कालीन जो सरकारें हुआ करती थी,
सर एक सेकंड बात सुन लीजिए, आपके भाषण हम लोग सुन रहे हैं, आप हमारी भी सुन लीजिए सर, बहुत आपको फायदा होगा अगर हमारी बात सुनेंगे तो। सरकार अगर सुनेगी तो आपको सरकार को बहुत फायदा होगा। जवाब देना जरूरी है लेकिन सुनना बहुत जरूरी है सर। आप अगर हमारी बात सुन लेंगे, हम लोग आपके नागरिक हैं, आप हमारे खैर ख्वाह हैं, अगर आप हमारी बात सुनेंगे तो हमें तसल्ली होगी कम से कम कि आपने हमारी बात सुनी। आप जवाब तो खैर नहीं दे रहे, भाषण देते हैं, हमें उपदेश देते हैं लेकिन आप भाषण देते हैं। आपको मैं ये पूछ रहा हूं कि उस ऑफिसर के ट्रांसफर ऑर्डर में रीजन क्यों नहीं लिखा है, उस लेडी ऑफिसर के आईपीएस के ट्रांसफर ऑर्डर में कोई कारण क्यों नहीं लिखा गया है? आप जवाब दे सकते हैं मिस्टर प्रकाश?
I want to bring in Ajay Dubey. Obviously Prakash Mirchandani has no answer there for Amit Khemka's question. Ajay Dubey has been listening very very quietly. Ajay Dubey, अगेन वी हैव अ प्रॉब्लम जब सरकार इस सारी चीजों को समाज पे ओके वी डोंट हैव दैट कनेक्शन येट बट यू यू नो एंड आई एम गोना ब्रिंग बैक स्वरंजीत सेन इनटू दिस होल थिंग। इट डजंट सीम लाइक द मध्य प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट हैज एनी पॉलिटिकल इंटेंट टू सॉल्व दीज प्रॉब्लम्स मिस्टर सेन।
Yes, that is how it seems. But I think we have to dwell on the police response, which has been terrible.
Inko bol do, I'll have
to. And you know, there's one problem which this country is facing for time immemorial, and that is non-registration of FIR. Can't we find some way to ensure that FIR is registered? Probably you outsource the system. At least registration should be done in a master computer, and then transfer the case to the police station so that the police station has no business not to register it and carry out the investigation. Why is that not being thought of? It just so happened that when I mooted this idea as DGP, it was too short a tenure and I could not get it implemented. Otherwise, I would have liked a master computer where you give your complaint, you get a receipt, and automatically the case is transferred to the concerned police station and it is recorded. It goes to senior officers, especially in specially grave nature crime as such. Everyone knows that this is a specially grave nature crime. So what have the supervising officers done in this case?
Right, I want to bring in Ajay Dubey. Ajay Dubey can hear us now, and Ajay has been listening very, very carefully. Ajay, आपने कहा कि मध्य प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट की ऐसी कोई इंटेंशन ही नहीं है प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व करने की, और यहाँ हम सुन रहे हैं मिस्टर मीरचंदानी ये तो मतलब समाज पे डाल रहे हैं पूरी प्रॉब्लम अभी.
We are going towards a banana republic at this rate.
अजय,
what has happened in Pradyuman's case?
देखिए, बीजेपी के पास या जो भी रूलिंग पार्टी है, दो तीन बातें रहती हैं कि हमने सरकार बनाई और हमारे संस्कार. अरे मेरा कहना है कि हमारे संस्कार नहीं, हमारे संस्कार ये हैं कि हमारी पुलिस उसका केस 72 घंटे रजिस्टर ना करे. हम 14 साल से सरकार में हैं और हमारे यहाँ ऐसे केसेस लगातार हो रहे हैं. आज 2 साल की लड़की के साथ एमपी के डिस्ट्रिक्ट शिवपुरी में रेप हुआ है, वहां पर लोगों ने आग लगा दी है. ये जो ग्रेव नेचर जो आप बता रहे हैं, ये जो केस हुआ है फर्स्ट, उसके बाद लगातार रेप हो रहे हैं. एमपी को यदि आप रेप कैपिटल बोलते हैं तो गलत नहीं बोलते हैं. भोपाल रेलवे स्टेशन में 2 दिन पहले 12 साल की लड़की प्रेग्नेंट मिली है, उसके साथ रेप हुआ है और उसके साथ गैंग रेप हुआ है. उस पर भी पुलिस अभी एक्शन नहीं ले रही है. हमारा यह कहना है कि सीरियसनेस, अकाउंटेबिलिटी क्या एमपी गवर्नमेंट के पास है ही नहीं? आप संस्कार की बात करते हैं, आपको इस्तीफा दे देना चाहिए. और आपने किस पुलिस ऑफिसर के खिलाफ अभी तक केस रजिस्टर किया? आप और एक बहुत लंबी जो डिबेट हुई उसकी सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट बात बताता हूं कि जो हमारे यहां के ट्रायल कोर्ट, हम लोग ग्रास रूट पे देखते हैं कि कन्विक्शन क्यों नहीं होता है, क्योंकि जो ये जूनियर डॉक्टर है गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉय है ही नहीं, इसकी कोई लीगल अथॉरिटी नहीं है. जो इसने एमएलसी किया ये तो एक तरह से मतलब डैमेज कंट्रोल के लिए इसको कहा गया था. ये डैमेज कंट्रोल है. उसका कैरेक्टर जो आप स्पॉइल कर रहे हैं बच्ची का, उसको आप ये सब चीजें कर रहे हैं. और इतनी देर हो गई, सुबह से लेकर शाम हो गई, कोई सस्पेंशन नहीं हुआ. आप किसी पुलिस ऑफिसर को केवल ट्रांसफर करा, आपने उसके अलावा कोई अकाउंटेबिलिटी फिक्स नहीं करी. और भोपाल में एमपी में लगातार रेप केसेस हो रहे हैं. आप भैया, आप संस्कार की बात करते हैं, आपकी पार्टी राष्ट्रवाद की बात करती है, बच्चे बर्बाद हो रहे हैं, तो क्या बच्चों ने कोई गलत संस्कार थे वहां पे? वो क्या 4 गुंडे थे, उनको बच्चे ने पकड़ा, आपकी पुलिस नहीं पकड़ पाई, आपके डॉक्टर हर कंसर्न कर रहे हैं, ये कहां है? उसके खिलाफ एक्शन लाइए ना आप, रिजल्ट लाइए, आउटपुट लाइए. आप केवल ये बातें करना कि हम देख रहे हैं, हम गंभीर हैं. अरे गंभीरता 4 लेने गई, हमें एक्शन चाहिए. बच्चे रोज बर्बाद हो रहे हैं. आज अभी की घटना है 2 बजे की, जिसमें 2 साल की बच्ची के साथ रेप हुआ, क्या उसके भी संस्कार थे? आप हर जगह यही बात करते हैं, आपकी गंभीरता फील्ड पे ग्रास रूट पे नहीं दिख रही. आप सजा नहीं दिलवा पा रहे, केवल आप एफआईआर दर्ज कर रहे हैं और इसके अलावा कुछ नहीं कर रहे.
एफआईआर भी दर्ज नहीं हो रहे हैं. अजय जी, मिस्टर नायर ऑन द फोन लाइन फ्रॉम भोपाल
हॉस्पिटल सब. अरे मध्यप्रदेश के सीएम ने एक बार उससे बात नहीं करी, मध्यप्रदेश के होम मिनिस्टर ने एक बार बात नहीं करी.
मिस्टर नायर इज ऑन द फोन लाइन फ्रॉम भोपाल. मिस्टर नायर, गो अहेड, व्हाट डू यू वांट टू से?
I actually want to say that this is what is happening in all the government departments, not in the police and medical line, the whole of the police, government departments of Madhya Pradesh. Nobody is bothered to take anything seriously until and unless it is politically motivated.
Yeah.
That is what they are. They are not shielding these guys and all. They are all gundas. They are not shielding. It is shows they are inconsistent towards the matter. They don't bother about anything. All are shielded. All the high officials of the government departments are shielded.
This is why I say we are heading.
Yes, Mr. Sen.
A banana country where there is a nexus between police, politicians, criminals, and all these cases are showing there is. What about the case which happened in Haryana, the Pardhuman case? What else is it if it's not this? We are heading towards a banana government or banana country, just like Colombia or any other place, and God help us. And this tendency is being noticed more and more in the last 3-4 years. This is what I want to say. I have never said this before in any of the debates, but this is what I'm feeling, and I cannot hold myself back because this is the response that we are getting now.
What a shocking statement to hear from a former director general of police of a state to say we're heading towards a banana republic, which is a complete breakdown of law and order. It is shocking. A shocking state of affairs in the state of Madhya Pradesh. When after the chief minister came forward and said this is a serious, serious case, we see it come apart like this. So what happens to all of the other cases that are not in the media glare, that are not being commented on by the chief minister? If this is not a complete breakdown of law and order, if this is not a complete abandonment of the women of this country, what else is it? Who are we to trust now? If not the police, not the doctors, not the government, not the judiciary, if nobody is on the side of the Indian women, how are we going to survive? We've made these sort of hollow slogans about Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. This was a 19-year-old girl who was traveling at a train station to study and to take an exam. What sort of face is the Madhya Pradesh government going to show its people tomorrow? What is this constant and perpetual failure of systems we have in our country? Shaming the victim. Suggesting on a medical report that she had consensual sex with 4 people in a cement pipe of a sewage drain because she wanted to. And then to turn around and say that this report was a clerical error? Was it written by monkeys? A doctor's report needs to simply talk about the kind of injuries the victim has and whether or not the person has any injury that suggests forceful entry. The doctor's report is not supposed to talk about whether or not she had consensual sex. How dare you? How dare all of you? How dare the state of Madhya Pradesh? How dare the Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan? How dare every single minister in his cabinet? How dare you? And this was a young girl whose parents were police officers who had the ability to fight the system, to read the reports, to challenge, to question and bring it into the media glare. What about everybody else? The 2-year-old girl who was raped in Madhya Pradesh today. Who's going to fight for her? How much longer are you people going to run this scam where half this country is treated like non-entities, like non-human, like subcategory? How much longer do you think you can keep us down? Shame on Madhya Pradesh today. Shame on you twice over. You have no right to continue in your seat as Chief Minister. You failed us all. I hope you don't sleep tonight.